Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today we're going to talk about how to maintain your DTF printer if you print at least three times a week. Yeah, I know the printer looks a mess, but it's beaten every single day. Here's what you need. You need a square bottle. I'm going to put a link in the description. You can get that from Amazon. Secondly, you need some distilled water. This is distilled water machine. It's about $100. I use for making coffee and also for clean printers. Here's a daily routine that you have to do, and you can fill that square bottle with distilled water, and you don't need to add anything, just water. So you shut the printer down first, then you restart. When you start, the printer is going to move to the left. Just wait a second, it'll move left eventually. And when it moves to the left, expose the cabin station, and quickly squirt some water, fill that box, and you're done. Believe it or not, that's all you need to do. And the second day when you go to office, you do two head cleanings if you use the RIP software, or one medium cleaning if you use the adjustment program. This routine works if you print every day or every other day, including Sundays, okay? If you want to leave your printer more than 3 days, you can add some water solution in the bottle, so mix it with water. And I'm going to put the link to concentrated water solution on the upper right, and also I'm going to put it in the description. If you have a humidifier, you can keep the humidity above 50%. That's also going to help for it last longer. However, this printer is in the office, so we don't have that control, but just by doing this simple thing, we maintain it without any problems. Look at how even that white is. Twice a week, we're going to add some extra to the closing routine. Again, you restart the printer, and once the carriage moves to the left, if you're facing the front of the printer, shut the main power off, so the carriage can be freeze right here. Now turn the main power back on, and turn the printer's power on. When you turn the printer's power on, you can see the carriage going to raise up. When you hear this sound, shut the main power off again. So the carriage is on the left and also raised up. Now get some towel or t-shirts. I like this towel HDX from Home Depot. At first, I make the towel wet. I just soak in water and then squeeze out the water. And you don't want it damp, you want it wet. Now you can see why we want the carriage to move to the left, and also why we want to raise up the carriage so we can have enough working space. Now I slide the towel underneath the printed carriage, and I start doing shoestring. You can see a big pieces of dried ink start peeling off. Now I slide the towels underneath the printhead and start forming a nest or something to keep the printhead moisturized. With the printhead protected, now we're moving to the cabin station. We're going to suck from the waistline. This little thing called a TMS, very simple, you push that button, it's going to suck from the shorter end, and it's going to dump ink out from the longer end. So we connect the waistline to this shorter end, and then we put a longer one into the waste ink bottle. Again, I'll put the link above and in the description. If you don't have this machine, you can have somebody holding a big syringe and suck from here. With the TMS sucking, so I'm going to just squirt water. And also I use my finger to massage the rubber seal around it, make sure there's no breaking and make sure there's no ink deposit on it, because you will need that seal to seal airtight so you can do the effective printhead cleaning. Now I'm taking out this wiper, and also I use my finger to massage it, and you can see I already have some more dried ink accumulated there. And I just squirt some bottle and keep massaging it. Don't worry, there's no electronic underneath, and also there's an absorption pad underneath, so your water going to absorb by the pad. You only do this twice a week, the pad will be dry next time. You can hear the TMS is working in the background, and you can see there's white ink accumulated there. The white ink is going to clog your sponge later if you don't clean it. and keep squirting until you don't see any white left. Also, if you don't wash out those inks from your system, it's going to clog up your tubes and make it less effective. You can see the right side of tubes is not flowing, it's clogged, so my chemist station is only 50% effective, and I need to take it out and get it serviced. I'll put a link to how to service your chemist station above. Most printhead cloggings not start from the printhead, it's starting from your capping station. You can see as long as you get 50% effective, you do the daily routine, still your printer works pretty well. I sell brand new Epson printhead on my webpage, and there are people bought the printhead, say, hey, it's not working. Why it's not working? It's brand new printhead. And then they find out their cabin station is totally clogged. It cannot prime the printhead. Okay, a couple minutes later, now you can see most of them are clean water now. So now not only your pad is clean, but also all your tubes are clean now. Now don't forget to disconnect the TMS and put the waste ink tubes back to the waste bottle. If you use your husband or wife in the back to suck ink, and give him a reward. Now we move back to the carriage. You haven't done the shushan yet, because you're holding the carriage moisturized, and there are more things peeling off. Now we're going to put a light source here, and we squat down at the same level as the printhead. Now we start checking if there's anything still hanging underneath the printhead. It'll be helpful if you move the printhead around a little bit so you can see it. And here's a big chunk that you need to take off. And here are more some smaller pieces that you need to take off. After it's clean, do your daily closing routine, fill the cabin station with water, and park your printhead on it. For every week, I do my color rotation. You'll probably realize that not all the colors die at the same time. Most likely your white is going to go out first, and then the blue or cyan, and then the black, and the yellow and the red never dies. So just like you rotated your tire on your car, I rotated the position of the white inks every week. So I rotated from my right to left and just keep going. You can rotate one position time, or you can rotate two position time. Now in the RIP software, you can go to setup and change the color. See, the last time when I rotated, the 2W is here. So now I move one slot over. So WW and MC. And don't forget, click save. And OK. And now it's in the current color sequence. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to squirt every day. Please visit us at www.bchtechnologies.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers.